Beirut, a broken city. This is the sick heart of a country which has been at war with itself for 13 years. There's only one crossing point linking the two sides of the divided capital. The people being checked here are citizens of one country. Over 150,000 people have lost their lives in the civil war, many at this very crossing. The civil war in Lebanon escapes any clear-cut definitions. Its religious and sectarian problems often conceal the real causes of the conflict. Rival militias fight each other and fight among themselves. They turn Beirut into a street theater of war, a performance which the children of Lebanon are only too happy to act out. They are the war generation.
My name is Nida. I'm 13 years old, with five brothers and sisters. Once we all went to school, but because of the war we had to drop out. I can't read or write, but my brothers and sisters can. School was fun. There was lots of fighting with the other boys. I got knocked about a lot, but it was fun. I've been an apprentice mechanic for a year now. Soon I'll be able to repair cars myself. Part of the job is to collect metal from the scrapyard to melt down. I'm the one who has to bargain with the scrapyard boss. He always tries to charge me too much, but I never let him get away with it. I know what things should cost.
أعطيه مفتاح البجيت يوسف، معه مفتاح البجيت؟ أعطيه مفتاح البجيت معه؟
قوم هذا شو؟
عالطاولة عالطاولة جوا. ودي
مفتاح.
ناولوا إياه ناولوا إياه.
ما كانش يتلقى أنا على المدرسة ولا شيء.
I didn't really like the lessons at school, but if I had the chance I'd go back. When I see the other kids going to school, I feel sad. Sometimes, before I go to work, I drop into the school and sit at one of the desks and look around. But I have to go to work. Our family needs the money. The war has been bad for our family. There has been a lot of fighting in the streets around our home. You hear guns, you see rockets landing, people lying in the streets, people screaming. Often we have to get dressed at night and run.
شو بيخطوا ولاد؟
لا يا ماما هيدا هالوقت بيخوف. شو فكرك يعني؟
بيخطفوا سعدين شو؟
اللي عم يتحذب من شو؟
هلا people are poor now. War is very bad.
اوكي خطفوني بقوني بميايير.
يلا ماما يلا. غسل.
هون شابت خلاص، ما عادش بدنا نشوف يد اللي عليك شمعت، شايفة الشبشب عليك، شايفة يد اللي عليك شمعت.
منا عارفينين والله يا أمي. شوفي بعد اللي ما حرمونا فيه. ملت نفسنا من هالحياة ومن هالعيشة هاي. عيشة بقى. قلبي ودلي. شو ما صار فينا يا أمي ما بتعرف.
لأن
مش
محبوبنا
مش على بعض.
ايه
شو بدنا كبيت
عشان
نعطي راسنا؟
ايه
يا امي،
فكرة معين.
شو
كيف
هالشغل معك اليوم؟
والله
الحمد لله، طلعنا
حق كبيتنا وكلتنا، شو بدنا؟ رحت أنا بدي أجيب خبز اليوم، لقيت في عجقة، قلت يا مرة ارجعي على البيت لتكون خفت العجقة شوي، بتعملي لك شغلي بالبيت شي. جيت على البيت أنا، إجا هالصبي. قلت له روح يا أمي جيب خبز. شو رأيك؟ عربت الخبز. بلشوا برصاص
بكون ما في عقل. قلت لك واحد مصلح عليه بس بدني بخاف تشكرش. اعطينا 10 ضبطات للمكتب، هو بحاسبك بامرك رئيس. بعد شوي ببصوله ايش بيعطوا بصير يطلع وديك مع الطريق واقفين ناطرين. مع اني شفتي هذا ابن نحل طرقوه ضربه هون براسه على علي، قال لي شو بك ما ثق، عطيك ضلوا هاي باربع بركين مات المعطر
يا دلي انا.
طيب عملوا حرب لحتى يحصلوا حق الناس، وين ياكلوا حق الناس؟ ليش صرنا بنطع ياسين قاعدين على خط التميس؟ واحد يموت وواحد بيتنقص وواحد بيعرج وواحد
كذا. يا حرام يا حرام.
وبعد الحرب وكل ما هو الحرب عم يزيد علينا مش عم ينقص عليك.
اخ يا واني رئيس هالدوله بس.
اللي عن ابوه العقرب، اللي عن ابوه العقرب. يا ريتك
وشايفك تنقطع
يا صاحبي. يا امي
فيني. عم يدور ما
رح نخلص من الفقنين.
لا يا عم مشتاقين يا عمي، عم صار
شو تعود. انا هيك.
Every Sunday, I help my father with his business. He has a stall in front of the cinema.
ممنوع اللمس، قول ممنوع اللمس.
لا
لا خلص بعد بدنا له خلص صابر علينا. حط بعد حط
حط بعد حط
بعد صابر علينا.
شو بعدك بعدتك زابير؟ بعدك زابير؟
خلص صادي زينين.
Man, I'm only sure what we should have.
There's not much time to play. I get fed up and try to dodge the work. I play when I can. I daydream. Sometimes I go to the movies. They show films about war and karate. That's all they show.
I hear the rules dance if you want to go back to the States. No, I have nobody left there. You tell Americans goodbye.
Well, fuck off.
بس بلش الأفلام نبدأ نكذب بالكراسي.
When the lights go down, they start the film. That's when the fun begins. We tear up the seats and whistle and shout.
يا محمد!
Our favorite game is fighting. Like the grown-ups, in our games we are big heroes. We play tough, but we play for fun, not like the real gunmen. They play for keeps. One false move and you've had it, you're dead.
When the war began, they said there were good reasons for fighting. I don't understand it really. But now they say they're defending the country, they turn around and stick you up.
In this world, the move from play to reality is a short one. Adoud is a 19-year-old right-wing militiaman. He's been training since the age of 13. He's never left his neighborhood in East Beirut.
يا حي مثل ما شايفها، شقفة خشبة وشقفة حديدة وهي كبسة زر تكبس راحوا على بني آدم. شو هي خرطوشة يا حي؟ شو يا حي؟ هيدي هي بتخليه ينتكل لبني آدم، هي الشقفة اللي فوق هيدي بينتكل وروح بزور الأبدية. شو بدك تعرف؟ شغلة صارت عندي مثل كرعة المي، صارت شغلة الحرب. الله يسترني من كلمة أنا، يعني شو بدك؟ يعني ما في مجال، صرت بلقط البارود مثل كأني عم بلقط لعبة، يعني ما في مجال. أنا بقوس فيها مثل كأني عم باكل شحابة بومبون، مثل كأني عم بسلي شي وحدة. عادي، شي طبيعي يعني. كل واحد بده يفوت على منطقتي الشرقية، ما بعتقد إنه بفوت صاخ سليم، لأنه ما بدي خلصه وبدي أكله لحمة. نقول انه كانوا يفكروا يفوتوا علينا، الكائن من فلسطيني، من املي، من شيعي، من اشتراكي، من درزي، من الى اخره، من حتى بدي خبرك يعني كردي مردي كلهم هدول ما محرم يفوتون فوالا وكلهم. انا انسان عسكري وحرب ومحارب وكل هالشيء هذا، بس ضلني انسان بآمن كثير، بآمن بربي، وخصوصا يعني بشفيعي ماري الياس. يعني تصور لوينه مثلا دقه على صدري، دقه على صدري وهون دق الصليب. طب بتعرفي الشيطان بيلعب براسه للواحد؟ في شيطان، في عزراين يا لطيف عزراين، شو بدي اخبرك عنه؟ ساعة اللي بتلاقيهم 30 40 شاب قاعدين وقاعدين طاق 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 تحشيش على الحياة. يعني هيدا طب مثلا شو مستنظر منه يعني؟ شو بدي خبرك؟ السكس ببلش، العربدة بتبلش، لعب قمار ببلش، أني قصص بالعالم بتبلش.
For all the bravado, the realities of street fighting are hard to live with. No one gets used to constant fear, constant danger. On the west side of Beirut, a 23-year-old tells youngsters how to make life of the streets tolerable.
مش بطل تسمع، يعني ما بفكر بحدا.
طب انا بدي ضلني افكر بامي واخواتي.
امك واخواتك؟ هيدي امك يا حبيبي.
هات لبوس امي. يا امي.
هلا بتنزل. لو نزل هلا 100 صاروخ عليك يأثر معك؟ طبيعي. عجبتك بدي تزرق؟
زرتها منيحة، مش مثل باقي العالم بزرقها عاطلة.
هلا هيدي صدقت فيها.
بس بلش كسر أنا بتروح معي.
يعني ها ما فيك تقعد بلبنان.
ليه؟
يعني مهما شو ما عملت حالك ما فيك تقعد، لو عملت حالك مثلا كلب يعني تمشي بالشارع ما فيك تقعد فيه. شفت كيف يعني القصة؟
خلتنا نحن كلاب، هيدي اللي ما بفهم.
مش نحن كلاب يا ريس.
نحن
هلا نحن الكلاب اللي عم تسوينا كلاب.
ايه.
هلا انت مثلا هذيك مرة شفتك عم تلزق صور شهداء على الحيطان.
طيب نلزق ليش؟
ما بتفكر مين بيجي حدا يلزق لك صورتك يعني؟
ما مشان هيك نحن بنلزقهم.
هلا انا شو بساوي مثلا انت؟ بقول لك شو تساوي؟ هلا كبر صورتك انت. يعني بتبروز صورتك بتعمل لك
بيبقى التاريخ بس
100 طبعة 100 طبعة يعني قد ما بدك بتعمل عزوقك انت، ورد ما ورد وظبط شو بدك تساوي امورك كذا، بتعلي صورك على العلالة مشان العالم كله تشوفك وموت. بعد عرفت كيف؟
ليك يا زلمه ليك، شو خلي شو طب غير ما شاطبه بايده؟
ما هيدي لما كنت اخذ حبوب اجي كسر بالقزاز، امسك السكينه هاي السكينه هاي هي مسكها هيك وبلش يطب بحال، بس شوف الدم هيك بهدل اعصابي. ايه يعني حقيقة لا في مصاري ولا في اشغال ولا شيء ودايرين على الزعلانة. جيت انا شو مشاكل بالبيت ومشاكل، حاولت انتحر.
شو السبب اللي بيخليك انه تشرب وهيك؟
كنا بالنبعة صار الحرب وكذا وتهجرنا. هلا شوفيت اللي كنا نشوفه بالنبعة، إذا مرة فايت أنا على حسينية، عرفت كيف؟ لقيتها كلها قتلة، شي 300 قتيل بقلب الحسينية
فوق بعضهم؟
إيه، شي منفوخ شي رايح إجي وكذا، أنا صغير يعني، شو بدك يعني يطلع مني يعني.
This war began in 1975, but the reasons behind it go back a long way. Take me, for example. I was involved right from the beginning. My family was very poor. My father worked in a nail factory. We hardly ever saw him. I remember there were many houses in our neighborhood that never saw the sun. Ours was one of them. Our house was one damp small room. The ceiling dripped on us. Five families shared the same bathroom. We had to share the same kitchen as well. It was tough growing up in conditions like this. Say at night you want to sleep or just stare into space. Well, you can't. Because your brother's sleeping here, your sister's sleeping there. There were 13 of us sleeping in one tiny room. Then, of course, your mother and father would want to sit together, sleep together. You couldn't help overhearing them. And you felt embarrassed.
كنا كثير نسمع ونحن اولاد شوارع. صحيح يعني نحن اولاد شوارع.
People called us street children, street kids. That's just what we were. We spent our lives on the streets, or we went to play around the rubbish tips. We would look for bits of metal to sell. If we were lucky, we might find a broken toy to play with. We were on the streets from morning to night. There was nowhere else for us to go. We used to swim near the sewers. The streets of Beirut were not just a playground for us children. Our families needed money. We used to go out and sell chewing gum, cake, cigarettes, anything. It wasn't fun. It was exhausting for us kids. But you had to do it. I remember how some people used to look down on us. Once a guy kicked my tray of chewing gum out of my hand. It was terrible for me. I cried. But you knew then that you couldn't just go and tell your parents. This sort of thing was your own problem. You had to deal with it yourself, alone. We grew up fast. In 1967, we started to hear about the Palestinian resistance. We went to the refugee camps a lot and got to know the people. We saw they were poor, like us.
Yeah.
Shatila is one of several refugee camps in Lebanon. The Palestinians took refuge here after they lost their homes when the State of Israel was created in 1948. There are now over 300,000 Palestinians in Lebanon. Shatila has known massacre, siege, and starvation. Today, 80% of the camp is in ruins. Salim grew up in Shatila.
My family is from a village in Palestine. It's no longer on the map now. It was destroyed by the Israelis in 1948. Some were expelled, some were killed. My grandfather was killed. I was born in Shatila, here in Lebanon. But I always knew I was Palestinian. The camp kept us together. My mother and other women talked about Palestine so much. I almost thought we were still living there. But we weren't. We were in a refugee camp, in tiny shacks, in narrow alleys. There were so many questions in my mind. I felt there must be something wrong. The camp was terrible. The rain came into our houses. I would move our beds so they wouldn't get wet and put buckets to catch the drips. The Lebanese authorities kept us under strict control. I remember how the Secret Service listened under the windows at night. In fact, a funny thing happened once. Somebody's window needed fixing. They went to the top religious leader in Lebanon, but he couldn't do anything about it. He was afraid that the authorities would accuse him of helping the Palestinian to stay here in Lebanon for good. There was a lot of pressure on us. People had had enough. When the Palestinian resistance movement developed, we saw in it a hope of regaining our land and improving the conditions in the camp.
As children, we used to look up to the resistance fighters. We tried to imitate them. We thought they could do everything, like jump off the fourth floor. We wanted to grow up to become like them.
During all the troubles, we tried to lead a normal life with our own songs and dances. It was a way of keeping ourselves alive. I've always loved to dance, ever since I was a little girl. The grown-ups would chase me out of the club. They said I was too young to dance with them. But I'd sneak back in over the wall. That's how I learned. I feel that music flows in my blood. حياكم الله ومرحبا حيا الرجال الثائرين يا حلال ويا مالي ويا حلال ويا مالي من شعبنا رمز الفدا ومن ثورته على الغاصبين يا حلال ويا مالي ويا حلال ويا مالي يا ديرة دي لا تزعلي بكرة الحبايب راجعين يا حلال ويا مالي ويا حلال ويا مالي بكرة بيجوا ربعي وهلي وبيرجعوا لك كالمي يا حلال ويا مالي ويا حلال ويا مالي
Lebanon was ruled by a coalition of privileged groups drawn from the many different Muslim and Christian communities. Dominated by the Christian Maronites, this coalition felt itself threatened by a new alliance between the Palestinians and the less privileged Lebanese majority.
Unless you understand what Beirut was like before the war, you can't understand why the fighting started. It was then that my generation began to develop political ideas. This was something new for us. We began to see that some people lived very well in Lebanon. Most of us didn't. I was working then as a decorator. I saw how some people were living better than others. I worked in houses with 10 rooms, fitted carpets, beautiful wallpaper. At home, we didn't have any furniture. In a way, we were impressed with what we saw. But it gave us a sense of grievance, a sense of injustice. You started to ask yourself a lot of questions, and we talked about it. We'd say the country needs changing, it needs burning. Walking around your own city, you felt like an outcast. You didn't share in its riches. We were ready to do anything to get change, to carry guns and, if necessary, to use them. We'd go to demonstrations and break everything in front of us. We'd break up pavements, tear down street signs. We were a generation that wanted to do something. All my generation were like that. When the war began in 75, I was 16. I went into it with a lot of enthusiasm, a lot of excitement. We shared a vision for the future of our country. It was the right-wing militias that started the fighting. But our generation saw the conflict as an opportunity to change the system and at the same time to support the Palestinian resistance movement in the camps. We began to realize that some of the causes of the conflict go back more than 100 years, to the period of French influence in Lebanon in the 19th century, when we had the first sectarian massacres. Before that, Christians and Muslims lived in peace together in this part of the world. The war gave me a big chance to express all my anger. I was able to work it out of my system, the feeling of being downtrodden, of being nobody. We went to fight in the downtown area. There was going to be a battle. I saw the Holiday Inn hotel. I worked in it before the war. Now, when I saw the broken glass, the burned carpets, I was really happy. Really happy. And I'll say so till my dying day. And when the St. George's Hotel was burned down, I was happy too. I was happy because I remembered walking on the beach by the big hotels and seeing yachts and people sunbathing. All we could do was look. We owned nothing. We had nothing to lose. You might die in the war, but who cared? Nothing was important to us anymore. If there was shelling, we'd go out anyway. I was hit more than once. I was lucky to live through it. During the early days of the war, we had a sense of purpose. We fought in the mountains, in the hotel district, here, there, and everywhere. You couldn't see the problems that were to come. You still thought the war would fulfill your dreams. But then a stalemate developed on the front lines. We had some setbacks. This is when the problems really started. The fighters were just sitting around, taking pot shots at one another. Any idealism went right out of the movement. The different factions started fighting each other. The various groups became more like gangsters. There was a lot of hashish about. There were armed robberies everywhere and intimidation. We began to see the war was going nowhere.
Then in 1982, the Israeli invasion began. Beirut was under siege for 3 months. Thousands were killed. The old political groups were swept away to be replaced by religious and sectarian factions. The conflict now increasingly took on some of the aspects of a crude sectarian war. Old allies turned against each other. The Palestinians suffered badly. Their fighters were forced to leave Lebanon. Over 2,000 civilians in the camps were massacred by right-wing Lebanese forces, acting, it is believed, with the connivance of the Israeli forces.
The worst time I have ever known was the time of the massacres at Sabra and Shatila camp. It all happened so fast. I prayed for time to go backwards, just 2 days, so we might have the chance to do something, anything, to stop the killing.
I didn't think that they would carry out a massacre. But on Friday, the 18th of September, 1982, armed men knocked at the door. There were 13 of them. They made us line up against the wall and they started shooting at us. 5 died, including my father. I was hit and paralyzed. My mother and sister were also wounded. My brothers managed to hide. The soldiers came back once more. They hit me on the head and I lost consciousness again. When I came to, I found that my father was still breathing. I discovered that the bullet had hit him next to his heart. I tried to help him. I couldn't. And he died. At night, the cats came round. They could smell blood. I tried to shoo them away, but I couldn't move. I felt I was going mad. After 3 days, someone heard my cries. He came and carried me to the hospital. Every time something new happens, I remember, especially with the recent battles.
هلا نحن الشباب الفلسطيني حاليا فينا نسميه جيل
We Palestinians are the generation of the camps war. We had to live through the period after 1982. All these massacres, sieges, we feel our very existence is threatened. This place, this camp, is our very being. Since 1982, people have become more divided than ever. For a long time, I was scared to walk in Beirut, scared to walk through its streets. I felt the danger that someone could kill me at any time. Even at university, I'd be sitting in the classroom and I'd find people watching me with hatred in their eyes. That feeling was with me all the time. When the uprising happened in the occupied territories, everyone cheered and said the Palestinians were heroes. I started telling people, here, I am Palestinian like those people. I am one of them. Why are you killing us?
Enthusiasm for the stand of the Palestinians on the West Bank and in Gaza has, for the time being at least, lessened the pressure on the Palestinian population in Lebanon, just as Salim had hoped. But less than a mile away, young men from the warring groups still man the barricades that divide Beirut. The idealism may have gone, but the killing continues. A generation of young men know nothing but this, life on the barricades. The target only a short distance away, who is no stranger, but in all probability, a familiar face, a name, a one-time neighbor.
Now I feel there is a real sense of division in the country. We have become divided along sectarian lines. How can you justify the killing of little girls and the skulls of children stacked up in piles, the kidnappings and the killings? This wasn't what was behind the original movement, our movement. Now the war is much worse, more brutal than ever. Those at the top don't care. It's the same on both sides. Each battle creates 6 or 7 new millionaires. They live off the killings. And it's the best of our generation who are being killed.
هذا لا بتنشله هو على المحور منه زلمه
لا مش دخلك انا
بضل يقول لك كلمه
مش لحق اجيب
اسمك يا ابني روح بتخبى بالبيت
بقول عليك
شو اخذ 14 يعني
بقول هذيك المره قعدت بديش من 6 ساعات تبكي اخذت تحت
بيك عزيفة هيك لك ليش تحكي بعد
وجاي يهر لك سنانك
يهر سنانك من يستر ستر جردون القرود
نعم لا
سمفور طرطور
الامر محور
الامر محور
لك من شت لي لا
راسك تكسر بالورقه
لك العاب يا عم
والله يا حالتكم حالة البلد بتضلكم تتخانق شو كيف شغلك
بس أي شغل يا زلمه خليتنا الحرب شغل لا مستقبل فيه لا لنا ولا شيء
هاي حال الحرب
بس اي حال انت شو فارق معك اخي قاعد بجامعه لك كيف
بلد
كل كلنا
بلد
ضيق هيك مستقبل ما بقى لنا لو حاجت الا اكلينا
والله ناطي يجيني يقول مسافر عامل
انت بتقاتل غيرك بيصير معه عديرات العالم تطلع ظهر ناس يطلع ظهر ناس
مش منا سلاح وما عرفنا لشو احنا منين
خلينا جيلنا طلع جيل حرب بينا بالحرب ما بعرف شيء
لا لا بالورق نافع ولا بالمدرسه نافع كان ولا حتى بالحرب ما كان
هذا شيء هي على شايفك الشباب مثل اللي ملاحظ
شو
يا بسافر يا بموت يا بنحبس
مش عاوزين هدول كلهم بهالبلد هيدي مثلا انه شو بدهم شو هدفهم بالحياه انه شو يعملوا يعني يبنوا الحرب بالعالم يبنوا شو بدهم ليه ما بيتركوا مثلا انسان ينبسط يعني بكثير قصص بقعد افكر مثلا اوقات لحالي مثلا انه انا مثلا شو بعدني قاعد عم بعمل انا افترض بلبنان ليه ما بروح اسافر بفل شو بدي بقى قاعد هون مش عارف شو مصيري
مستقبل المشي بعتبره يعني مستقبل الكتر انه اكتر شيء انه تروح عامل مرتزة بفرنسا وانا هيدي شغلة فكر فيها
Some have suffered from the violence without being directly involved in the fighting like Yusuf
بدي اتحدى الحرب لانه بالنتيجة في قتل في قمع في اذى في حرق في دمار بعتبر انه في شيء اقوى كثير من الخوف هو الامل بحس انه في نهايه لهالقصه بس من ايمتى ما بعرف
انا عم بحكي معي اسم شغله
ابرجها
والله عجبني هالشاب كويس كان عم يسالنا بيقول لي شايف قلت له الحرب هيدي قلت له والله انا حرب تجليت وهيك قال لي ايش حامل بغودي؟ قلت له انت ايش حامل بغودي؟ قال لي انا حرب فردت علي اياهم دولتي لو اي كمان حرب فردت علي
لو شافك طرعك كيف
لا والله بظن
اخ انا بظن
شو ربيع
شو عم تحكي معهم
والله هلا حكينا معهم
والله
حكينا مع طاني
هو بحكي معهم شو
يا ابو شمعه
ابرجع قلبي معك رح احكي لك غني لك بخير
يا مروني ابو شمع
يا انا
يا حبيب عليك يا ابو شمع ركز صحتك يعني انت حابب تكب البارودي ولا لا لكن سعيد طبعا بدو حرب وانت ما بدك حرب وشو بتقدر تعمل انت ما طالع بينك تعمل شيء يعني حابب تروح لحالي يا حبيب قلبي يعني بكره لما تفتح الشرقيه على الغربيه نتبوس مع بعض
ابو ربيع هاي كلمة
يا ماروني
جميل ها ها قدام خرج عم تحارب شو؟
لا يا حياتي
الحرب أنا برأيي صارت بين ظالم وظالم، يعني سواء هذا الظالم كان
Now the wars between political tyrants, both Muslims and Christians. People are being crushed, destroyed on both sides.
رغم كل الخيبات والإحباطات ورغم أني
Despite all the setbacks and the fact that I am now against the war, I still feel our society must be changed.
ترجع قوي